Hey guys, it's Mr. B. So today what we're going to start is the Altered Masterpiece Parody Project. I used to just do American Gothic, but since we're doing this digitally, I thought we'd expand and bring in another famous work of art. So by the end of this PowerPoint, I'd like you to be able to say first that you can identify the paintings American Gothic by the artist Grant Wood and Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci, and describe the subject matter of each painting. Second, I'd like you to be able to explain what a parody is, what parody means, and then be able to give some examples of parodies in popular culture and everyday life. Third, that you can explain the techniques that make certain parodies successful, and what makes certain parodies unsuccessful. And then lastly, that you can explain theme as it relates to the subject of an image. So there's a handout that accompanies this video. It will be in the shared folder on Office 365. So you just need to go back to the email I sent you earlier in the quarter. When you're done with the handout, save it and then email me a copy so that I can give you a grade for it. Once your handout is done today, you'll be able to watch video two. And after that, you can begin your own project. So, what is American Gothic? American Gothic was painted by an artist from Iowa named Grant Wood in 1930. At the time, he was actually working as a painting teacher in a small town called Eldon. And while he was walking home after teaching, he passed this farmhouse. So this was a real place in Eldon, Iowa. And as he walked by, he kind of imagined the type of people that would live in a house like that, and did a sketch on an envelope that he had with him. Right there. And so this was his original sketch on that envelope. Wood based the characters for his painting on people that he thought were kind of typical Midwesterners at the time. Now it's the 1930s, so something was going on in the United States that you've probably heard about in the 1930s. There's a question about it on your handout. We'll see what you guys remember. The man in the painting is an aging farmer with a tool that he would use around the barn or around the farm or in the fields. And then the woman is actually supposed to be his unmarried daughter, who's kind of dressed in plain clothes and ready to kind of help and serve her dad around the house. Now, there's a lot of interpretations of this painting. Some people have said that because there's black curtains drawn, that and they sort of sorrowful expression on their faces that the mother in this situation has passed away, and they're actually it's a mourning photo or a mourning painting. Some people have said that it's just kind of a stereotypical image of people from the Midwest. It's kind of up to you to decide how you feel about it. As for the subjects, Wood originally wanted to paint his neighbor for the woman, but he was too scared to ask her, so he ended up painting his sister Nan, and the man is actually his dentist. He entered the painting in a contest at the Art Institute, actually, and won the contest and then sold the painting to the Art Institute for $600. Now, today it's probably worth tens of millions, but it's one of the most famous works of art, American works of art from the first half of the 20th century. So the second painting we're going to look at or use for our parody or potentially is called the Mona Lisa. Mona Lisa was painted by the artist Leonardo da Vinci between 1503 and 1506. This is a pretty cool self-portrait I found of him. So it's believed that the portrait is of the wife of a guy named Francesco del Giocondo, who was a merchant during the Renaissance, and he commissioned the painting of his wife. Now nobody knows for 100% certain that is the case, but it's pretty widely believed that that's it. Now, despite the simple subject, which is just a lady sitting and looking, there's nothing too fantastical about the painting. It's endured as kind of one of the most famous, most discussed, most parodied works of art of all time. And you can see this is a picture of it in the Louvre in France, which is a very famous art museum. It's not particularly huge, but they have it completely blocked off from visitors. They have glass covering it now. It's actually been stolen at one point back in the early 1900s. So it's estimated it's worth $787 million. I don't know how they come up with that figure, but that's a lot of lunch money right there. So, what is a parody? A parody is a work of literature or music or video or art that is, number one, it's based on something else, based on another work of art, of another work of music or video or art. And then it makes fun of it by altering it in some way. Now, a good parody resembles the original so closely that it can be mistaken for the original. And will make changes that are strange, humorous, sarcastic, or sometimes even mean. And there's a lot of different examples of parody. I need to take a drink because my throat is getting dry. So, delicious Bolt House Farms Protein Plus Mango flavor. I highly recommend it. Okay. So, parody magazines. I don't know if either of these exist anymore as magazines, but when I was a kid, Mad Magazine and Crack Magazine would have a parody sort of comic book of movies that were coming out at the time. So the left-hand one, you can see it's a parody of The Incredibles. There are parody novels. Barry Trotter and the Unauthorized Parody makes fun of the Harry Potter books, obviously. The Hunger Pains makes fun of The Hunger Games. There are parody movies, and there was a point in the 2008, 2009 area where one of these came out every week, it seemed like. But Scary Movie makes fun of horror movies and would parody lots of scenes and moments from famous horror movies. Not Another Teen Movie is the same way. It makes fun of, teen romantic comedy movies. There's also parody music. And so I've both of these videos will eventually be part of this video, but for the moment, they are available in the Office 365 video channel for this class. So what I want you to do is watch the first minute and a half or so of the Michael Jackson video, and then the first minute and a half or so of the Weird Al video. And what we're going to do, I want you to write down on your handout a few ways you can tell that Weird Al's song and video are parodies of Michael Jackson's song and video. And once you're done with that, come on back here and go to about 7 minutes and 30 seconds, and you will be ready to continue in this video.
Thank you. eat it. Don't wanna argue, I don't wanna debate. Don't wanna hear about what kind of food you hate. You won't get no dessert till you clean off your plate, so eat it. Don't you tell me you're full, just eat it. Eat it. Get yourself an egg and beat it. Have some more chicken, have some more pie.
Welcome back. It's Mr. B from the future. So what I have now is just some examples of American Gothic parodies. The first ones are ones where the characters have been replaced with new characters. So Miss Piggy and Kermit, Mickey and Minnie, this is George W. Bush and his wife Laura. And you see they've replaced everything in this version, including the objects that W is holding and the building in the background. They've changed to the White House. Simpsons. And then this one's kind of a Halloween-themed one where they've been replaced with cats. You can see all the Halloween decorations in the house. Bats up in the sky. A little owl over the barn on the right side. And then the dragon. I don't know why the dragon is there. I don't really think of dragons when I think of Halloween. And then there's other parodies where they alter the original characters. So instead of keeping the same characters from, replacing the characters completely, they keep the same characters and change their costume or slightly change their faces or what they're wearing. So here's another Halloween one. The man is dressed as a devil and the lady is a witch. This is an old Time magazine cover from the 90s, and you can see there's, this is going to make more sense to me because I grew up in the 90s, sorry. But they changed it to have a lot of sort of 90s things added to it, laptops and vests, and she's holding a pair of rollerblades. They have their SUV parked back by the house. He's wearing the, oh, that's nice. You're going to enjoy hearing that blasted in your ears. Sorry. Anyway, he's got his John Lennon sort of round glasses on. It's a Forbes cover about the obesity problem in America. So they made the characters overweight, and he's holding a giant dinner fork. This is one that plays on the title of the painting, American Gothic. They changed the two characters to Goth. Goth-looking folk. The Gothic part of the name of the painting actually comes from the Gothic style window in the background, not because they're Goth. And then this is actually an American Airlines ad from the 70s that had them on vacation together, so he's holding a shuffleboard paddle instead of the pitchfork. So these are a few parodies of Mona Lisa, and we're going to do it the same way. The first one is with completely replaced characters. So here's Katniss, Miss Piggy. People like parodying with Miss Piggy. Here's one made of Legos. So even the landscape in the background is made of Lego. A minion, Lisa. Replaced with a character from the movie Avatar. And then here are some where they alter the original. So here's Mona Jedi. Or Jedi Lisa, I should say, astronaut, super buff Mona Lisa. top of the morning to you. Here's Irish Mona Lisa, and then selfie Mona Lisa. Oh my God, look, guys, I'm a butterfly. So, for your altered masterpiece parody, what you need to consider now is whether you're going to add new characters or alter the original characters. Sometimes alterations are more interesting than complete replacements. I'm not going to tell you how to live your life, but consider it. Like Weird Al, we want the viewers to immediately recognize that your image is a parody. Or even better, mistake it for the real thing. So think of ways that you can alter it to make it recognizable. For the actual parody, I want you to choose a theme and stick to it. And I have this totally awful theme listed here. If you choose American Gothic and then you change the man to Jay Cutler and he's holding a sandwich from Mr. Beefy's and he's standing next to Rihanna in front of the middle school, that's not a very well-developed theme. So try to make the characters in the background work together. Just a couple of things about the paintings. Mona Lisa's kind of just sitting in a kind of comfortable, quiet pose. The background is a landscape, so that means it's not a city. It's not a a house. It's just a landscape. So keep that in mind. For American Gothic, you've got two characters that are standing in kind of almost rigid looking, uncomfortable kind of poses. The character on the right is holding something in their right hand, and it slightly overlaps the character on the left. So the one on the right is usually slightly in front. You can see his shoulder covers her slightly. And there's also a building in the background. So that's an important part of how you make your theme as well. So for the rest of class today, finish your handout. Start thinking about which parody you would like to do. And whether you're going to replace the characters or whether you're going to alter them. And then lastly, find a good high resolution image of the original painting, whichever one you're choosing to do. Wikipedia has images of both works, and they're both excellent and super huge, which will be perfect for you to make your own parody. Just save whichever one you need to your student folder. And that's it for today. Tomorrow we'll start video two, and you can get going on your final project. Thanks, guys.